Hey guys, I hope you all had a great Monday. I am finally getting around to doing our classroom power tool. It's definitely been a Monday, so it's been a crazy day, but I'm excited about sharing our first classroom power tool. And how this is going to work is just every Monday, I'm going to quickly share with you guys a tool that I feel like you can add to your technology toolkit that will help make learning more meaningful for your students. I believe that if we're using the technology just to use it, then it's kind of a waste of time. But if it's a technology tool that'll help our students make connections and maybe take their learning to the next level, then we definitely need to find ways to integrate that into our classroom. So I'm going to show you tools that are easy to use. Most of them will be free. I will share with you some that aren't, but they have to be super cool if they're not free, right? But the tool that I want to share today is Dogo News, and that's the one I want to start off with because it's so easy and it's just really a great way for our students to practice some reading comprehension as well as learn about some things that are going on in the real world. So it's spelled just like it sounds, Dogo, Dogo, news.com. And it looks like this. And it is just a list of current events that kids would be into. It's current events that would be interesting for them. Really cool things, cool facts, things that are really happening in the world. And they love these. And you're going to understand why in just a second. So they have them categorized here. And they can click on a specific category. Or they can just search. And I don't give my kids an article. I let them choose because they're going to be much more engaged and much more willing to do what I ask if they're reading about something that they are interested in. So on this website, I do allow them to choose whatever article they want to read about. So let's say they're into skiing and snowboarding and they want to know more about that. And they choose this article. They simply click the article and it pulls up the article from Dogo News. There's a word search for them to complete if you want them to do that. And you'll notice that with the article, there are tons of images, there are tons of videos, there's lots of different things for them to look at. But within all of that, there is an article about whatever it is that they have chosen. And what I love is that they can interact with that article. So as they're reading, let's say they come across a word that they're not sure of its definition, they just click on that word if it's blue. And it pulls up a quick definition. So, boom, it's instant. They can understand what that word means, and they've added a new vocabulary word to their vocabulary. So, they can, as I said, they can scroll down and continue reading. If they come across a blue word that is a location or a place on a map, they can click on that, and it pulls up a map. I think that is so awesome. And they can see immediately where that place is located. And geography is not a skill that we spend a lot of time on, unfortunately, anymore. And so I feel like this is a great way for students to see where places are located in comparison to where they are. So you can see it shows the map. And if I click on, let's say we wanted to see United Kingdom, they can simply scroll out or scroll in to see where that is in reference to where they are. So, very cool tool for them to use and to be able to see actual definitions and actual places on a map. Makes the learning a little more real and a little more meaningful for them. So, as they scroll down, they can watch a video. There's some more locations for them to click on. Lots of cool facts. It's things that kids think are super cool. And then, how awesome is this? At the bottom of the article, Dogo News has already provided three article comprehension questions and a critical thinking challenge. So, what I encourage teachers to do is have some index cards over at your computer area or wherever you have your desktop computers, or even if all of your computers have all your students have a device, maybe just give them a note card or let them answer these on a blog. But give them those note cards and ask them to, on the front, number 1 to 3, and answer the article comprehension questions after they've read the article. And then on the back of the index card, answer the critical thinking challenge. And then they can give that to you as kind of an accountability, being accountable for what they've done. So I read the article, Here's the proof that I've done that. And it's just a great way for them to engage in new learning. So if students have already completed, if they've completed their work early, or if they've already mastered what you're teaching and don't need to hear it again, this is a great option for them. It's a great way for them to learn something new. I feel like students should be able to do that in class, that if they have already mastered what you're teaching or they don't have anything to do, give them an opportunity to learn something new. So Dogo News is a great tool. It's a great, it's a very easy way to engage your students in new learning. So if you guys have questions about this, feel free to put those in the comments. Or if you've used Dogo News in your classroom and you want to share how you've used it and how it's worked for you, feel free to do that too. That would be awesome. So I hope you guys have a wonderful week, and I will be back next Monday with a new Classroom Power Tool.